Hello, and welcome to the UiPath AI Computer Vision. Today, we'll take a look at the computer vision activities which are now available in UiPath Studio. First, we'll compare the selector-based activities with computer vision in order to understand the benefits that this new feature brings. We'll then go into detail about how to use the computer vision activities. And finally, we'll take a quick look at some of the best practices in building solid automation workflows that incorporate AI. Let's begin. Here is a workflow that contains a simple click, which you're already familiar with, followed by a set of computer vision activities. As you can see, the activities are included in a CV screen scope, but we'll get to that later. Now, let's see how this normal click works on our test applications. If we select Indicate on Screen, we can see that in this desktop application, all elements are easily recognized when we hover the cursor over them. However, if we move on to the VDI environment here, we cannot interact with any individual elements on the screen. Only the buttons at the top of the window are recognized because they are part of the desktop app. In the web browser, the same thing happens. We can interact with some elements, but the fields in this image are obviously not recognized because it's just an image. Right, so that was the normal behavior. Now let's see how computer vision handles these applications. We'll select Indicate on Screen again, but this time let's try using a computer vision type into activity. All the fields in the application are identified, so there's no difference in that regard. The very same application is open in the VDI environment. With the simple click activity, we could not perform any action here. But with computer vision, we can interact with every element, text, input fields, buttons, and checkboxes. And because computer vision works based on how things look, it also works on the image in the web browser. We can detect input fields, text, and also the submit button. Pretty cool. Alright, now that we've gone through the capabilities of the computer vision activities and how they differ from the normal approach, let's see them in action. We'll start with an empty workflow and add a CV screen scope. We'll agree with the terms and conditions here. We'll indicate the application, the RDP window in this case. By doing that, we generated a selector that's used at runtime to get the screenshot of the application and analyze it. If we double-click the informative screenshot, we can see a preview of that image and the results of the analysis with the detected elements highlighted in blue. Next, we'll add a type into activity, select Indicate on Screen, and then click on the field where the text should go. When we do that, computer vision automatically selects an anchor and generates the appropriate activities, one to find the label and the other to actually type in it. We'll just add some text to be typed here, and done. Now, two blocks were generated in the type into activity, as we've just mentioned. The one on the left contains the anchor text, while the one on the right contains the input field itself. Now we can easily modify our field selection by clicking Indicate on Screen again, and then choosing something different, say this one. The activity was updated and the anchor was detected automatically. So, the Indicate on Screen option enabled us to change our selection altogether. Let's see what happens if we select Edit on Screen. The anchor and the field are displayed, and we can edit or remove any one of them. Let's say that we want to select a different anchor. We need to remove the current one first. The color of the fields has changed. The red color in this field indicates that we don't have an anchor, and the yellow color shows us the fields that are similar to our current selection. Those fields are also called false matches. On the upper left corner, we are notified that we need to indicate the anchor, but we've seen that it works, even automatically, so let's try something else. We'll pick a different field, such as this one, as well as a new anchor. The color of the fields changed again to orange. The explanation is once more mentioned in the wizard in the upper left corner of the screen. There are duplicate matches, so we need to choose another anchor. So the wizard provides details about the selection and notifies us if anything is wrong. If there is no problem, the fields are colored in green. So, to recap this final part, Yellow indicates similar matches to the currently selected one, and red is displayed if there is no anchor, or if the current anchor is not valid for the target. Orange signifies that there are duplicate or false matches, so we need to inspect our selections to see what's wrong. Now, in this particular case, we could solve the issue by making use of the image automation feature. To do that, we simply need to drag, click, and draw a rectangle around a unique anchor. And it worked. The selection is colored in green, which means that everything is fine. If we look at the wizard on the left side, we can see that the target and the anchor are okay. We can hit enter now. The activity was updated once again, and our selection is displayed in the type into activity. Let's click edit on screen again and remove this anchor. Another feature that might be very useful sometimes is the ability of selecting a part of the text or a couple of words. The fields are orange, which means there are duplicate matches. For now, we can stick with the selection that solved our problem earlier and hit enter. Now, let's see a very important aspect when it comes to computer vision, refreshing the scope. Let's say that we perform some actions in a certain screen of an application, and then we're led to a different screen. In that case, because the screen changed, we need to add one more CV screen scope activity for the second screen. Why is that? Well, because the screen analysis is cached in each screen scope individually. As a result, all the activities inside a screen scope actually work on the analysis performed by that specific screen scope only. To demonstrate this, let's use a click activity to navigate to a different screen in our application. First, we select Indicate on Screen, and then we choose Withdrawal to navigate away from this screen to a different one. Let's run this workflow. As you've just seen, it typed the value in the Cash In field and then clicked Withdrawal, and the screen changed. Now we need another CV screen scope for the activities that are performed on the new screen. We'll add a new screen scope and indicate the application again. Studio is running computer vision and OCR to detect everything in the application, and now it's ready. Let's use the Get Text activity to retrieve some data from this screen, for example, the transaction number. We need to store the result in a variable, which we'll call transNumber. Now we can output the number to a message box. So let's enter the variable we've just created here. Before we run this, let's go back to deposit. So the workflow consists of writing this value in the cash in field, going to withdrawal, and retrieving the transaction number. Let's go back to Studio and run the workflow. And here is the transaction number. We can click OK. One more useful option when it comes to computer vision is error reporting. Now, it's a very valuable action because based on it, we can improve the machine learning model to ensure that every single element will be recognized in future versions. To see how errors can be reported, let's select Edit on Screen. On a side note, we could do this in the Indicate mode too, without a problem. Now let's imagine that a certain region on the screen is not clearly visible. If any such region exists, we can simply click R, which is the reporting shortcut, and select that specific area. Every element in the application was recognized, but if there was an unidentified one in here, this is how we'd report it. To validate the selection, we can hit Enter. Report successfully sent. So, please report any unrecognized elements, as that will contribute to improving the accuracy of the computer vision activities. Okay, we can close this for now. That's about it. But before we end the video, here are a few best practices to use when automating with computer vision activities. In some situations, we might need to isolate a portion of the application and work only on that. Now, this approach can avoid some false matches issues and also speed things up a bit. So first, instead of clicking the entire application, you can drag select a smaller region. In our case, we don't need anything in the lower region here, so we can surround the area that we're interested in and ignore everything else. If we look at the screenshot, we can see that it only includes the selection we have just made. Another recommendation is to store selectors in variables. If there are a lot of screen scopes, in order to avoid indicating it every time and update everything more easily if needed. To do that, copy the selector, create a new variable, we named it selector here, and paste its value in the default column. Now, before we end our demo, let's go over one more useful tip. The default OCR engine used in CV screen scope activity is Microsoft OCR. But it's a good idea to try all of them out if you run into any problems and see which one works best. Abby, Google Cloud Vision, Microsoft Project Oxford Online, or Tesseract. At the moment, the Google Cloud Vision or Abby OCR engines might return the most accurate results. All right, that was all for today. In this demo, we've seen what the AI computer vision activities look like, how they work, and when they can be used. Thank you for watching.